Let's hear the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
Life is short. I always tell them, life is short. In a matter of minutes, you will lose your loved one.
We begin in New York, where grieving Filipina mother Leia Lilo boarded a Philippine Airlines flight to bring home the remains of her 35-year-old son, lawyer John Albert, who was shot by an unknown assailant as they were in an Uber on their way to the airport in Philadelphia on June 18.
Nakastop yung car nung binaril kami. I can remember yung nag-shattered yung glass ng door. And then nakita ko siya bigla na dumudugo. Dumapa na ako, lumuko ako. Kasi I want to save myself. I was trying to pull him down.
The Philadelphia police continues to investigate the shooting, which they believe could be a case of mistaken identity. Meanwhile, in Los Angeles, the man caught on video verbally and physically assaulting a Filipino family appeared in court on Monday afternoon. Nicholas Weber did not enter a plea for the hate crime and battery charges he is facing for his May 13th attack on the Roque family at a North Hollywood fast food parking lot. Instead, the public defenders asked for a continuance to July 11th. Still, for the Roque family, it was important to see Weber in court.
I didn't recognize him at first, but now that I realize it, I was like, okay, so there isn't nothing to be afraid of about this. He's in custody. Case is still ongoing. We're still continuing from this. This is not the end. This is still the beginning.
The Roques and their supporters also delivered a letter to the district attorney's office.
It expresses how many organizations are very concerned about what happened to the Roques, and it really pushes to ensure swift justice for the family.
And finally, we head to Daly City, California, where Filipino nurses joined in a two-day strike against Seton Hospital. They demanded that the hospital's owner, Advanced Healthcare Management Corporation, or AHMC, provide them with a better contract, along with enough nurses to safely care for their patients.
They hired a lot of nurses, yes, that's true, but we also have a lot of nurses that are leaving because of the situation that we're in. We still don't have a contract, and that's what we've been asking for 6 months now.
The nurses, who are represented by the California Nurses Association, say they continue to have a heavy workload.
We are already experiencing shortages with just even support staff as well. So as nurses, we're doing not just patient care, but we're cleaning rooms, we're answering call lights. We're doing a lot of stuff that's taking us away from our patients.
AHMC says they have been offering the nurses fair compensation and safe staffing, and yet their more than fair offer has been rejected.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.